being at other levels has been out of town. And we'd like you all to know that each of you are invited during the day because you play an integral part in your intertwining lives. As the Bible reminds in Corinthians, love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast. It is not proud, it is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no records of wrongs. Love does not complain in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always repents, always trusts, always hopes, and always perseveres. Love never fails. In the time that Andrew and Samantha spent together, they built a sturdy foundation for a long, lifelong relationship. After a great deal of thought and consideration, they have decided to bind themselves to one another for the rest of their lives. May you all remember and cherish this sacred ceremony, for on this day, with love, we will forever bind Andrew and Samantha together. Marriage is a sacred ceremony. Today we observe the union of these two people with respect to the occasion wants. What we honor with reverence, however, we also celebrate with great joy. For married life, a shared life, is a tremendous blessing. Now, as Andrew and Samantha embark on this journey together, they will be able to nurture a love that makes each of them better versions of themselves. Marriage is indeed the perfect garden from which to sow and harvest personal growth. Andrew and Samantha learn to work together, to laugh together, and to love together. Don't get caught up in worldly things that will draw you apart. Instead, focus on your shared devotion and turn inward. As your relationship strengthens, you will find that you come to share a remarkable love, a love that is both abundantly given and freely accepted. The joy you'll find as you pursue your shared lives will fuel you to face head on the challenges you'll encounter on this earth. On your journeys together, keep your spouse in the space of highest priority in your heart. The love you share must be guarded and cherished. It is your most valuable treasure. Under the eyes of God, I solemnly consecrate these matrimonial proceedings and the sacred covenant we shall both enter into on this day. Marriage is an ancient rite. As you enter into this union, you are choosing to take part in a historical human establishment and are pledging your commitment before the witnesses present here today to enter into that tradition with honor. As Jesus said, have you not read that he who made them all as a thing made them male and female? He also thought that for this reason a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So then, they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, let not man separate. Andrew and Samantha, the sacred vows that you made to one another today present you with the opportunity to express your love in your own words. I would at this time invite you to publicly declare these vows. Andrew, you may begin.
I, Andrew, take you, Samantha, for my lawfully wedded wife, for having to hold from this day forward, for better or worse, for richer or poorer, I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. I will love you, honor you, all the days of my life until death do us part.
Samantha, you may now make your promise. Sensitive to her needs, to comfort her in difficulty, and to push full and complete.
take a note? I do, definitely I do.
All right, yes, Samantha, do you take Andrew to be your lawfully wedded husband with the understanding of making this commitment you are joining in the sacred covenant of marriage? Do you promise to honor him in love, to be sensitive to his needs, to comfort him in difficulty, and to put your full and complete trust in him so long as you both shall live?
Thanks for coming, everybody. We are going to do